morning! Hi, it's Maxene from Manila. Sending you so much good energy from Hong Kong. Yes, I'm here. Just like I mentioned in the previous episode, I booked a random and spontaneous trip to Hong Kong. Why? Just because I wanted to. I just felt like it, and that's how I operate. I really listen to my gut feel, my intuition, and I honor that. And something inside me was telling me to book that trip. And good thing, Cebu Pacific really does have very, very affordable rates. Thank you so much, Cebu Pacific. I can be as spontaneous and random as I wish to be because of you. This episode, episode 4, is all about mental health. One of my favorite topics. This is really very, very near and dear to my heart because as you all know, well, those of you who follow me on my social media, I am a very strong mental health advocate. And I really believe that mental health, just like physical health, should be talked about in the world today, more openly about that we should be discussing and having these difficult conversations. Because honestly, if not now, when, right? So that is why for this episode, I am going to take you with me here around Hong Kong and show you how I help myself heal through travel and how I manage my own mental health struggles. And I am also here to say that mental health is about dealing with your own personal issues, knowing how to do that and how to heal yourself naturally without having to blame other people or without having to depend on other people. I want you to find out and learn for yourself how you can be empowered and how you can start your own healing process because I believe that you can do this. If I can do it, you can too. And I'm also here to share that no matter how far you travel in the world, no matter how many beautiful places you go to, as long as you are not happy in there, inside, you will never be truly, truly happy. So mental health is about facing what you need to face. It's about finally making that decision of taking control of your life because you understand that as an adult, you are 100% responsible for the energy that you put out into the world. So come join me. Come join me, have fun here in Hong Kong. And let me show you. Let me show you how I heal my mental health in the most natural way possible. And of course, lifting and offering everything up to God. So let's go. Let's have fun healing.
Malayo sa isang pamilya ko, lalo na sa mga anak ko.
Oh,
lalo na po sa lola ko, lola na ako.
Oh.
Love you, Mom! Oh, love you!
Kayo, kamusta naman?
Ay, mahirap, Mom. Mahirap mahiwalay sa mga pamilya. Lalo
na
maraming
anak. Oh. Eh, kamusta naman ang mental health ninyo?
Okay
naman. Anong ginagawa nyo kapag nalulungkot kayo? Ayan.
Pinapanood po kayo.
Dapat magdasal palagi, ano?
Oo.
Tama. Ayan.
Thank you.
I usually like taking the train because taking the train here is very efficient and also you get to walk. And then, sometimes, especially now, it's raining, a little bit of rain. We are actually supporting the taxi. The taxi drivers, we are supporting their business and we are very grateful for them because, you know, they have been here for so long already. They look really cool. The taxis in Hong Kong look really cool. Very vintage, cool style.
So we just got here to Lai Chi Kok Park.
This is where we will be meeting Ate Iris and hopefully a few of our other OFW friends. Because today is a Sunday and I actually didn't know that this is the day off. This is the only day off of the OFWs here in Hong Kong. And on Sundays, they usually always get together and hang out. And then tonight, we are very fortunate to be able to speak to one of them, to a few of them, so that we can actually find out how they're doing here, how is their life here, you know, so that we can... Para pwede natin silang kamustahin. Let's go! So, nandito pa rin tayo sa Lychee Kok Park. Mm-hmm. Kasama natin si Ate Nikki at Ate Ivy, ang ating mga brave OFW workers
gandang dito ulan. Sa...
I love it! O, diba? Nakita ko sila dito by accident lang. Hindi naman natin plinano. And I think it's meant to be na nagkita tayo dito. Hindi
yes.
po ba?
Yes.
Naniniwala po ba kayo doon? Coincidence?
Oo. Oh.
Diba? Ibig sabihin may meaning yun. Meant to be to.
Kahit maulan, no?
Yes. Kaya nga, actually, perfect po talaga na nakita ko kayo dito. Kasi meron lang akong mga a few questions that I would like to ask sa ating mga OFW kababayan dito sa Hong Kong.
Okay.
First, I want to know, kamusta po kayo dito?
Well, very fine, very okay, and comfortable kami kung ano ang narating namin dito. Hindi kami tatagal ng 22 years, 23 wow. years dito sa Hong Kong kung hindi kami comfortable. Lucky lang talaga kami. Lucky ang Hong Kong sa amin.
Blessed kayo ni God.
Yes. Yes.
Ikaw naman, Ate Ivy.
Ako, 17 years na ako wow. dito.
Sumunod ka sa kanya.
Oo, okay. Sumunod ako after sa college ko. Mm-hmm. Dito na ako, nag-start. Until now, this is my second employer
wow.
since 2006
wow.
until now.
Wow.
This is my second employer na... Nandito pa rin ako kasi they treat me like a family.
Wow, that's nice.
And I'm very lucky for all my employer.
Wow, that's great.
Gusto ko malaman, ano po yung naging decision ninyo ultimately para lumipat dito sa Hong Kong at magstay dito at magtrabaho dito?
Ako, actually, galing akong Brunei pa. Tapos, as a single mom kasi ako. So, sa panahon ngayon, kailangan na hindi tayo maging weak sa... karanasan natin sa buhay o mga nangyayari sa atin sa buhay, laban lang. So, kaya ako nakarating mag-abroad kasi pag nandun lang sa Pilipinas, although na makakain tayo siguro doon ng 3 bisis sa isang araw, pero walang, hindi natin mapag-aral yung mga anak natin, walang edukasyon. Tsaka ako, hindi ako nakapagtapos ng college dahil nga sa ako naging panganay sa amin. So, naging breadwinner ako.
At kaya gusto mo rin yung ibigay
yes,
sa anak mo.
Yes, at ayaw ko maranasan ang mga anak ko yon kaya nagtiyaga ako. Wow. Lucky naman.
Wow, wow, wow. God bless you. Ikaw yes. naman, Ate Ivy.
Opo, ako din. Actually, nung pumunta ako dito, okay kami ng husband ko. But, alam mo naman, buhay Pilipina.
Ay!
Ang hirap mawala
So, ano yung mga ginagawa ninyo, lalo na sa mga araw na, alam niyo, nararamdaman niyo hindi kayo ganun kalakas or medyo may kalungkutan, ano po yung ginagawa ninyo para matulungan ang sarili ninyo?
Ayun. Actually, sobrang hirap kasi nandoon yung time na ako, like, gusto mong tumalon sa building, nandoon yun. Lalo na't malaman mo yung mga problema sa atin, dagdagan. Ang stress talaga, kaya lang, kapit lang kay God.
Tama.
Pray ka lang talaga, tapos isipin mo yung anak mo, isipin mo yung kapakanan ng anak mo, isipin mo kung bakit ka nag-abroad.
Mm-mm.
Doon ka na lang kumapit.
Totoo.
Huwag ka na lang susuko talaga. Laban lang.
Oy.
Survive.
Sarap! Woo! Sarap! Ang sarap! Thank you, ate! Wow! Ikaw naman, Ate Ivy.
Ako, pag, syempre yung mga stress, yung mga homesick talaga nandyan lagi. So, ginagawa ko lang is to chat my kids. Lalo na sa nanay ko, tumatawag ako na mag-video call. Siyempre, nababawasan yung stress ko. Kahit na anumang problema, pag makita mong okay yung magulang mo, yung mga anak mo, kapatid mo, okay na ako doon. Nakakahinga na ako ng maluwag.
Wow!
It's different when I'm sitting here alone all by myself. It's different when I think you might be with somebody else. It's different, it's different, it's different, it's different,
Okay, I'm in the middle of my run and I just had to take a minute to pause to share something with you that I just thought of just now. A download came in. I figured the reason why I love running and why I love to do it even on the days when I don't want to do it, especially on those days, is because I realized running trains you mentally and it makes you so strong that while you're running, even when you think you can't anymore, you just keep going. And that's just like life. You know, challenges come and you feel like you've reached your edge and you've reached the edge of the cliff and you want to jump. No, that's not it. It means when it's the toughest, when it's the hardest, that's when you must absolutely keep going and do not stop. That's it. That's one of the most important lessons that I learned because of running. And I love it. So if you haven't tried running yet, please do. Every day. It's amazing. Okay, back to work.
It's different when I'm sitting here alone all by myself. It's different when I think you might be with somebody else. It's different. This shit.
One of the things that really causes me so much mental stress is wanting to control everything around me. And that's just physically impossible in this world. So nature is there to remind us that there is really nothing that we can control here. God is the only one who is in control. We are here simply to enjoy this beautiful world. Yes, there are problems, but there are always going to be solutions. So that's why we need to take a break. Go towards nature, go to the ocean, spend time with the trees so that they can help you clear your mind and give yourself space and the clarity that you need to be able to come up with creative solutions for your problems. Always remember that when you are experiencing a tough time, it is not the end of the world. No need to panic, no need to stress. And again, always pray. Pray to God because this all came from Him. So just look at this and remember that God is always with you. Art is supposed to make you feel your emotions. It's supposed to make you think and tap into your own imagination. I believe that mental health is very, very prevalent in the world today, and there are a lot of mental health struggles because we all stay in our minds, and it's no one's fault. It's just how the world works. We have been too consumed by our overthinking minds, and so art gets us out of our heads and makes us go into our hearts, into our feelings, into our emotions. Yes, we can think, yes, we can analyze, but really, at the end of the day, whatever the artist was feeling in that moment, that was all feeling. So you can't really explain or like put a logical explanation behind that. So all you can do is just really appreciate the art. If it resonates with you, accept it, and if you don't like it, that's okay also. But again, the point of art is really to make you remember how to feel and to appreciate beauty. Whether it's something that you like or you don't like, it still adds texture and richness to this world. So art is very subjective, but what I believe art does is really it opens you up because it's so different. Every artwork is different from each other, just like all of us. So I feel that art really makes you feel your own individuality. You can see how expressive each artist is. Like Yayoi Kusama, she has her own style and she stuck with that. She never let anything or anyone stop her from being who she wants to be, and now this is the result.
That's why I'm so happy I got to see this, because it's showing me that I am on the right path, and I just want to keep going who I am. And she really does inspire me, especially now that I found out that she is living with a mental illness. Wow, she is a modern-day superhero. You know, she is choosing to use her art to help others heal. I'm very, very grateful to be here. See, this is the effect of art. So please, if you have mental health struggles, go to your nearest art exhibit. Support your local artists. It's time for us to stop watching TV and too much movies, too many shows. That's okay, that's fun too. But inject a little bit of art into your life once in a while and see what it will do for you.
May tanong ako para sa inyo. Anong masasabi ninyo sa mga taong mga nakakapagtrabaho sa Pilipinas kasama mga pamilya nila?
Mas lucky sila.
Yun na nga, bakit?
Bakit?
Kasi kasama nila yung pamilya nila.
Kayo ba nami-miss nyo?
Siyempre.
Nice to see you. Mag-hi kayo sa kanila. Anong masasabi niyo sa mga kababayan natin?
We are heroes.
Ah, yes. Totoo. Totoo. Nako, itong mga OFW natin, we have to be grateful for them dahil napakalakas nila. Sobrang inspirational. Napakalaking inspirasyon ninyo. Maraming salamat. Sobra. Sobra. Mahirap yun. Mahirap pero masarap yung pakiramdam mo. Diba? Sige, bye-bye. Sige.